All right, April the 9th, and it is 12:47 in Kansas City, and our temperature today is, if I can get it to focus in, 81 degrees in Kansas City. Good day for a cookout, sirloin strips and steak fries. So let's go have a look at the fire. All right, got our fire started here about, I don't know, 5 minutes ago. Doing a real simple one today. Just doing a couple of sirloin strips, and the fire, as you see, has started. Foil on my grill, my grates, which I always do. And so we got, I don't know, about a half hour wait, and our coals will be ready, and throw the steaks on. So we shall do that in a little while. Alright, looks like the fire is ready. So what we're going to do right now is we're going to go over here, check out our steaks, take them out, had these covered just long enough to just as I got them out. It's good usually to get whatever you're going to cook, kind of, you know, you want them to warm up just a little bit, get some of the coldness off of them before you put them on the grill. They cook a little bit better that way. And so there they are, two KC strips, and so we'll move the grill. I'll get the pot holder. I don't want to burn my hands. That's always cool. All right, so get them all set up, put them on, let them go. Oh man, it's hot. Should be hot. Okay, so here we go. We'll do it this way. Yeah, we'll do it this way. Alright, there's our steaks. Steak number one. These aren't really seasoned with too much. One, just a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper, which is that one. Mine, I put a little bit of seasoning salt on, which is this one right here. And so now, there they go. So we'll come back and check them out in a few minutes. And we're gonna close the top down on this while they cook. Or I might just leave it that open. So I think I'll just leave it open today. This, just, why not? So, hear them start to sizzle. I can start to hear them sizzle. You might be able to. No, maybe not, but I can. So, anyway, they are started. So again, it's gonna be steak fries and sirloin strips today. So, we will talk to you guys pretty soon when we turn them over, see how they're looking. Probably about 5-10 minutes. Okay, there they are. They've been on a little bit now. As you can see, the blood rising through them. It should have been already turned, but whenever you're cooking, you see blood rising up through them, that's a telltale sign to turn them. Or if they start to sweat, if they start to sweat along the sides. I worked in a steakhouse for many years, and that was two signs that let us know it's time to turn the steaks over. There's the first one, and of course, here's the second one. Okay, now, both are turned over again. Once they start to sweat, whenever you're cooking with a fat layer or a fat one, while it's beginning to marbleize down, render down, they'll start to sweat. That's a good time to turn them. So anyway, they're partway done. If they bled through, ain't no big deal. Just turn them over; they'll be fine. And so they're over, and we shall check back with them in just a little bit. I think I'm gonna close the top for the second half. But that's side one of them, or that's what was down initially. So stuff's blowing around, so I'm going to close them down, close this lid while I finish them up. All right, close down. We'll let them sit another few minutes, and then we shall check back with them and see how they turned out. Shouldn't be very long now. We got steak fries, I think, in the oven. They're getting close to being done. Steaks turned over, top down. Everything's about ready to go. Okay, it's been a few more minutes. We're gonna come out and see how they're looking. raise, of course we're gonna raise the grill. And those look good. What do you guys think? Let's see if we can't zoom in on them a little bit with my shaking hands. Man, I hate it. If you guys shake, I feel for you, man. And if you guys shake, you can relate. I don't know what it is. But anyway, that's not what we're talking about today. Cooking about a couple steaks. I think we'll give them a little turn. So, if I can get my tongs opened up, there we are. Give them a little turn. We'll cross them like you see them in the restaurants, you know. Like, they got those real neat little marks on them. So, let's see how they look. Doing stuff you guys can't see because I'm trying to look over the camera and do both things. Alright, so anyway, a couple more minutes. We're taking these dudes off. So I don't want them all well done. You see them starting to bleed a little bit right there? You may or may not be able to see them. So we're going to turn this one back over again. And we're going to move it down here where it's maybe not quite as hot. And we may do the same for this guy. We'll scoot him back. So they're going to be separated. The heat is really right in this area. That's where most of the heat's at. And probably should have cooked more, but only cooked two. Because there's only two of us here. So anyhow, there they are. A little more time, and they're coming off. And it's lunchtime. All right. Time to pull them. So let's get things done here. This might be a little bit of a challenge. Now we're good. All right. Here's our steaks. Done. Number one. And then the second one, number two. Onto the plate. Take these bad boys down. So you know I didn't put them on the porch. So anyway, zoom in. They look good. Look real good. They smell good. Like I said, too bad we only got more to cook because the fire, it always happens. When you're done cooking, your coals are like perfect for cooking. Haven't quite figured that part out yet. But that always seems to be the way it goes. So anyhow, and man, I wish I could hold this more steady. So zoom out. Anyways, there they are. Two strips, steak fries, and lunchtime. Saturday afternoon, 80 degrees in Kansas City. Hope it's warm and where you guys are. We'll talk to you later, probably. All right, there it is. There's my plate. Steak fries, baked potato, a little bit of ketchup on the side, and barbecue sauce on my steak. The reason you don't put barbecue sauce on your anything you're cooking outside, like right away, is because the sugars in like your barbecue sauces, your honeys, anything sweet, it's going to burn. And so it'll char up whatever you're cooking, ribs or whatever it might be. What you'll do, the best idea is to put on like 15, 30 minutes before, let it caramelize. And as things finish up, it'd be a lot better and it won't burn. I didn't put anything on them until I got them inside. But if I were to do that, that's how I'd do it. You'd put the barbecue sauce on last, outside the last 15 to 20, maybe 30 minutes max, so that you don't get the burn. So anyway, that's my plate. Talk to you guys later.